Friedreich's ataxia in KCR3 Health Watch. It's an inherited disease that attacks the nervous system. And today we're going to be talking about a fundraiser that will help benefit some research and fighting for this. Joining us now is Vicki Hardigan and her daughter Ashley. Ashley is suffering from this type of disease. And Vicki, does it fall under the big umbrella of muscular dystrophy?
It does. It does. It's a very rare form, so it's kind of like one of their orphan diseases. But quite frankly, without the support of the Muscular Dystrophy Association, my daughter wouldn't have a prayer.
Now, so and how does the disease impact an individual that suffers from it?
Basically, there's a protein that's missing in their cells. It's the energy of their cells. And that protein, when those cells don't have the protein, the cells die. It attacks the nervous system, the spinal system, the heart, the pancreas. And then as the nervous system dies, so do the muscles will atrophy, and they will.
Ashley, we had an opportunity to meet you 2 years ago at the MDA telethon. And so how has the year been different from you since I've last seen you?
Well, I just finished the clinical trial, so I lost a lot of my strength and stuff. And it's harder to walk and get around.
But you have certainly kept up your spirits throughout this, have you not?
Yeah.
To me, you're a pillar of courage in this, and you guys have done your fair share in helping raise money for this. Why is it so important for you to raise money for research?
Because then I'm that much closer to getting a cure and being able to run around and keep up with my friends and do stuff they can't.
You said, Vicki, over the last year, you've obviously seen the physical tolls the disease has taken on her. A lot
yes.
more falls. What are some of those things?
She really struggles a lot more to walk. Her energy levels are definitely a lot lower. She falls a lot. For a while, we had a walker where she had to use the walker in the house because she just couldn't get around as well anymore.
Mostly diagnosed in young people?
No. Actually, Ashley was very young with her diagnosis. Her onset was young. But we have three other people in the Sacramento area that weren't diagnosed until their teens. You know, so a lot of it depends on however much frataxin their body's actually generating.
Okay, so you guys are here today because you have a big crab feed coming up to raise some money for research. Tell me a little bit about it, Ashley.
It's at Ruby's Hideaway.
Okay. Yeah. And how much money are you guys hoping to raise?
$25,000.
Fantastic. And the money goes towards?
The money goes to the Friedreich's Ataxia Research Alliance, all of which goes 100% towards research.
And so you guys have been doing things throughout the year pretty much as well.
We're trying.
Okay, so I want to get this information out. The crab feed is to benefit Farah, as you just described. Saturday, September 13th, it's at Rudy's Hideaway. As Ashley just said, it's the Lobster House on Folsom Boulevard in Rancho Cordova. Dinner is at 6:30. Tickets are $45 each, $325 if you want a table of eight. All that money goes to research. For more information on how you can be a participant in this, you can log on to our website at kcra.com. Guys, thanks so much. It's good to see you again.
Thank you. All Very right. good to see you. Thank
All right.
you.